Hello, my name is Asa, and today I will show you how to make animations in Blender to use in Roblox Studio. The first thing that we are going to do is first open a place in Roblox Studio. Then we go to plugins, and then we are going to go to build a rig, okay? So we have here, I have it in Spanish, that it's construir rig, but it's build a rig. Then you select a rig. In this case, I will follow with, you can select the default one, that is the rig, this the block one, or you can select the one that I like is this one. There is another one that is the man, the pervert face, and also you have the women and Arthros, but in this case I recommend this one, okay, that is the mesh rig. So after that, you need to install this add-on that I will leave it in the description, that is Blender Animations, or you can try to find it in the toolbox. So you just enable the toolbox and you just go to check if you can install this plugin. So you go to the toolbox, then you go to plugins, and then you just try to check if you have Blender. And then let's see, yes, you have this one. So you just select this one and you just install this one. Okay, it is installed and that's it. After you install this, you need to install the version for Roblox, for Blender. Okay? But before that, the first step that we are going to do, we select the rig, we go to plugins, and then we just select the Blender animations, we select this rig, make sure that your dummy has the humanoid root part anchored. That's it. By default, it's anchored when you make it with build rig. Then you just select export rig and you choose a folder in your computer. So in my case, I will rename this as rig Roblox mesh, whatever. You wait a little bit. You have a bunch of files here. Don't worry, just clean meta parts. Here with the plugin, you can disable the plugin, and then we are going to go to Roblox Studio. But before that, we need to install a file. Well, we are going to go to Blender, I mean. So we go to Blender, and then we are going to import this rig using the plugin for Blender. Okay, first I open this place in the dev forum in Roblox, okay, for Roblox. Well, here, you must be locked in order to access to this thing, okay, so just create an account. And anyway, you are here and you go to this link that I will leave you in the description of this video. And you go for this part that it says Blender 2.8, 2.82, 2.91, okay? So you select click here and then you are going to find this paste bin thing. So you just right click and then you just select everything, I mean, not here. Well, you can select this like this here. I guess if you press Ctrl A, you select everything. Yes, or Ctrl E depending on your system. But I Ctrl A, I select everything, or you just can go and select everything with this. Okay, Ctrl A is the same. After you select everything here, you just select copy, and then you are going to create a new text document in your computer. So for example, I go here and then I have here some of my projects. And then you just create in any folder. For example, I create here in the desktop. I'm going to create in the desktop. Okay, I create here in the desktop. I'm going to create here a new file, new text document. Okay, you have this text document, the name, you can name it whatever you want, okay? But we are going to double click and we are going to enter here. We are going to paste. You have everything here for the plugin and then you are going to save it. Very important, this is the most important part. Save as, and then here in the desktop, I'm going to say like Roblox aniplog.py. Like this, guys. Okay, don't use the TXT, okay? So just like this, .py, and then you just save, and that's all, okay? Roblox Ani plugin. Then you go to Blender, open your Blender, and then you go to Edit, Preferences, and then you go to the part where you install the plugins, add-ons. You select add-ons here, and then you are going to select here install. You click install, you look for your file. Mine is in the desktop. Remember, Roblox Annie plugin, so annieplug.py. I selected install add-on, and then I have this. I have another one that is this one. So, but it's the same because it's just a copy that I made. Okay, but I guess we're going to use this one. Okay, so I'm going to disable this one and I'm going to enable the one that I use. It's the same, okay, just in case. I make sure that it's checked and I'm ready to import my rig. So I delete the cube with X and then I go here to file, import, and import you have a new option if you install it correctly. That is the RBX animations rig import. You select this one and then you just look for your rig. Mine is in this file here, rig.robloxmesh.obj. Remember, use the one, the option to import is this one. No, this one, okay? Roblox animation. Well, after you do that, you will see your rig. But before it moves everything, don't move anything. You just click here, press N in your keyboard or here. And then look for the option for the Roblox animation. Then you have to rebuild the rig. You click on this. And that's it. You have here the rig, okay? Now, if you want to center everything, okay, you can just center, okay? For example, if I press, in this case, I'm going to go here and I'm going to select the skeleton. Just the skeleton, don't worry for the pieces, just the skeleton. Press G, X, center, and that's it, okay? It is in the center. Now, these ugly lines, you can get rid of them just by, let's select again the skeleton. Press H to hide, then we are going to use the left mouse button in my case, I don't know if yours is different, and you select everything, okay, you select everything, and then you are going to press set origin to geometry, and that's it. Then you just press Alt H to show the skeleton again, and then we can select here this one that is to show us the texture, or you can just go to render preview, okay. This is the different mode. If you see, we can have like a transparency here. It's like a book. No, you just select here any part of the model. Then we go here to materials and you just uncheck show back face. And that's it. You press 1 in your numeric keyboard, numpad, I mean. And the model is facing backwards. Okay, so just to fix this, you just select the rig. You just press R, Z, check if this is like this, you need to select also for the skeleton set origin to geometry. Now press R, Z, 180 degrees, and that's it. You are ready to animate. In order to animate, you can go to this tab, the animation tab, and then in the animation tab, you press 1, 5, to have this view. You have here just like a preview with the camera. Don't worry, you just can put it whatever you want. You just enable here the textures if you want, or this render view. Select the rig or the skeleton and then go to pose mode, and then you have this. You can animate your character. Wow. You can use all the features in Roblox, in Blender to animate your rig. There is another step that you can make. You can have inverse kinematics, but I will show you that in the next videos. If you want to export an animation, it's pretty simple. First, you can enable this. For example, the easiest way to work for some people is like this. You make like the first, this is my first frame. Let's say that this is my first frame. I press I here in the pose mode, and then I select here location, rotation, scale, for only location and rotation. That's it, you have here this frame, but this animation is just for this one, that for this bone that is selected. In order to fix that, select all the bones, or you press A to select all the bones, press I, location, rotation, you have a keyframe for this. Then let's say that this guy is going to move over here and here and here and here and here. And then press A to select all the bones. Then just press I and location rotation. You have now these two frames and you have this kind of thing. You can then in this part in the dot sheet, you can have like you can copy these frames. For example, Shift D, I duplicate the frames that I selected, and then you have this one that it's returning to this place. Okay. Probably I want to modify this one and to move to the other side. And this one here, and this one here. And that's it. You have your bold animation. Don't forget, check. It didn't save my keyframe because I didn't press I. So in that case, you can just press here, move your animation here the way you want. For example, the face, and then select AI, location rotation. And then you have this. Okay, you can add more frames or things in between. For example, for this one, it's going from here to here. So let's add here a frame here, here a frame, select I, and that's it. Okay, and this one is going here. That's it. Select all and then location rotation. Okay. Now, this is important. You just select until where your animation. For example, I want to end the animation in the frame 40. You select here the end to 40. And then we are going to go here to the properties for the frame rate. I select 60 frames. And then I'm going to loop this animation probably. I'm going to select the first frames here with the right mouse button, Shift D, duplicate, and then I'm going to put it over here, and then I'm going to select here 60 frames, and then I just press and it's loop. That's it. So you have your animation and then you want to export it to Roblox Studio, no problem, just press here in the view, you are in pause mode, press end, and then you just look for the tab that it's for Roblox animations. You have different options. And then you are going to select export animation. It says bake animation data exported to the system. Okay, you go to Roblox Studio. Then you enter again to the plugin, select your rig, and then you select import animation. Then you have this screen. You just press Ctrl V and you have your animation. Now it's time to save your animation in Roblox. Okay, upload animation to Roblox. Select the name of your animation, for example, animation tutorial 00. You can write a description and then you just say send. Also, there are options that you can select here. For example, do you want the animation to be loop? You can click here or not, or yes. The priority of your animation, most of the animations are action, for example, action. Core, I don't use it. If it's an idle animation or idle animation, you select idle or movement or action. I prefer action. Okay. You can select all other parts. For example, I don't want the head to move. Okay. So you just uncheck the head and that's it. So on the head will be like in the same position, but this is just the way you want. And then you just press export animation. Well, I exported animation. I close the plugin. I test the animation in the animation editor. I click here. I select here my model and then I use import from Roblox. And then you wait. If it's not working because sometimes it gets bugged with this plugin, you need to open a new file. Okay. This is a bug. Okay. But I don't know if it's happened to you guys. Tell me in the comments, but it is happening to me a lot of times. Okay, so the way I fix this is just I open another studio or another base plate thing, and then I can use my rig. I can create it there, or I just Control C. I go here, Control V, and then I use this same rig. I press F to see. I go to plugins, Animation Editor, I select my rig, and then I go for import animation from Roblox, and it should work. If it's not working, yes, it's working. And then I check my animation, and yes, it's working, my animation. Okay, that I made in Blender. So this is the way you can work. First, you work in Blender, you export your animation, then you go to the first file, use the Blender animation plugin here, import the animation into Roblox, upload it, the animation, okay, import, upload, and then open another project where you are going to test this in the animation editor. Okay, so that's the idea. Well, that's all for this video. In the next video, I will show you how to use the inverse kinematics and other tips in animating Roblox Studio, animating a character in Blender for Roblox Studio, or how to make animations in Blender for Roblox Studio. Okay, that's all for this video, guys. I will see you the next time. My name is Asa. Bye bye.